Bueno, chicos, buenas tardes y como se suele decir, vamos a follarnos las mentes. Okay, guys. So here we have the very first episode of our beloved Sciency podcast. So I think it's interesting to be, just before we go on how what we're going to do things and whatever, just to introduce ourselves a bit and let everyone know who are we, right? Albert and Sergi?
Yep.
So for example, myself, my name is Pau. I'm from Castelló, from Spain. As you can see, I'm ginger, all over my body ginger, everybody. And I remember when I was in primary school, kids are very, very, very bad. And they used to call me Little Orange, in Spanish, Naranjito.
Can we call you Naranjito now?
You can call me Naranjito if you want. Yeah. It's like reminds me of my childhood.
Okay.
So on my left, I have my friend Sergi. He's playing for Gryffindor, his favorite team, and he will introduce himself now.
Bueno, como veréis, estoy hablando en castellano porque intentamos que el podcast sea básicamente que esté dirigido a un público diverso. Y bueno, yo, como ha dicho Pau, yo soy Sergi. Bueno, estoy hablando en castellano porque mi catalán es un poco malo, porque soy de Mallorca, entonces quizás no me entendéis. Pero bueno, y como anécdota mía y personal también, yo de pequeño a mí me llamaban Doraemon. Porque, como veréis, bueno, ahora no se nota tanto, pero tengo la cabeza un poco grande. Entonces, bueno, también podéis llamarme Doraemon si queréis. Y bueno, por último tenemos aquí a Albert, que bueno, te dejo.
My name is Albert. This is interesting because I think Albert is also a Catalan name, right? So
Albert,
a lot of times, different... when I say my name without people actually seeing me, they think I'm Catalan.
And then they see my second name.
They actually write emails to me in Catalan. This is super interesting. I mean,
right.
I don't understand Catalan, though I understand a little bit, like I mentioned before, bon dia and whatever. Anyways, my name is Albert. I'm Kenyan, actually, not Catalan. Super happy about this little project. It's not little, huh?
No.
It's gonna be big. This project that we're having here. I was born and raised in Kenya. When I was a little boy, this is also another funny story, my head was much, much bigger than my body. So they made a lot of fun on me calling me big head and whatever. Anyway, I think when I grow up, my body finally caught up with the size of my head. And now it looks more or less proportional, right?
It's
normal, no? And that's about it.
So to continue a bit with the story, do you remember how we met the first time? Do you have any idea what's in your brain of the very first time you met this ginger guy?
Actually, we met in Girona. I don't know if
we
you
met
remember
in Girona,
that.
Actually.
We met in Girona.
Yeah, right.
So Pau and I are both La Caixa fellows. We'll talk a little bit more about that later. And we met in Girona for a training. I had just come to Barcelona and there was this training for the PhD students that was organized in Girona. So I go to Girona and I think he was one of those people who was really close to me when we started talking in Girona. And he came and hugged me and then we started talking a lot and about lots of different things and this kind of stuff. Much later, we started hiking, discovering Catalonia.
A lot of hiking weekends.
Best way to discover Catalonia, hike. So yeah, we hiked a lot of routes, we talked a lot, and yeah, that's how we got to know, we became good friends.
And year after year, we were like getting to know each other and knowing that we had these things in mind that we wanted to communicate science better to the to everyone and to make everything easier to understand.
And you know, also to one of the things we figured out as we were moving along, like our friendship and many, many other things, is how difficult, you know, it is for young scientists to get discovered and whatever, and you know, just get that visibility and that kind of thing. And yeah, so we brainstormed a lot and came up with a few ideas. We'll talk about that a bit later. And Sergi, on the other hand, he introduced himself in Spanish, but actually he speaks English. We actually in the same university, but we never met until most recently.
Until 2 months ago.
2 months ago, yeah. We met through Pau, because he's a friend of Pau, but we're in the same university anyway. Yeah,
so
that's the long story.
The floor is yours, Sergi.
Yeah, well, so
Sergi,
our story with
comments,
Pau.
¿Cómo os van trobar?
Ah, ¿cómo os van trobar tú y yo? Perdón, voy a hablar en castellano, porque
sí,
así
sí, tú,
vamos a ser diversos.
Tú en español.
Pues bueno, la historia con Pau realmente es un poquito más distinta a la que tiene sí, con Albert.
Bastante, bastante.
Porque bueno, nos conocimos en la residencia de estudiantes, Ramón Llull. Y la mejor manera de conocernos, o la manera como nos conocimos, no fue precisamente de ir yendo de excursión, sino emborrachándonos, yendo de fiesta.
Íbamos de excursión a otros sitios.
Exacto, a otros sitios, a discotecas.
Other kind of hiking trips.
Y bueno, desde entonces hemos sido muy buenos amigos, ya llevamos 10 años conociéndonos y la verdad es que, bueno, encantado de estar aquí con él. Y bueno, ambos estamos haciendo, bueno, señor Pau ya es un señor doctor, como...
¡Oh, ya! Yeah. Pau is the only one among us who is actually a doctor.
Exactly.
¡Wow!
Exactly.
Congrats, man.
Yes.
So, well, perdón por el lío con los idiomas. Pues Pau ya ha terminado con el doctorado, yo todavía lo estoy haciendo. Pero como ha comentado Albert, también tengo un interés, o tenemos un interés común de intentar divulgar ciencia, porque vemos que es un mundo que todavía no está muy, muy al alcance, muy entendible para el público general, digamos. Y este proyecto es como, bueno, como ya contaremos más adelante, la idea es acercar un poco la ciencia a la gente.
Molt bé. Ara, un poc per a que la gent ens conega una mica més i sàpiguen qui som, crec que és important parlar un poc de la recerca que estem fent durant els nostres doctorats. Mm-hmm. Els tres, tant Albert, Sergi com jo, Pau, som doctorants, en el meu cas ja vaig acabar en setembre, i jo feia una recerca en el camp de la biologia vegetal estudiant un patogen de les plantes, que es diu Ralstonia solanacearum, i intentant veure com sobreviu aquest bacteri en diferents condicions, dins de la planta, en diferents plantes, i aleshores aquest coneixement en conjunt l'hem aprofitat per intentar conèixer un poc més aquest patogen tan perillós de cultius humans com són la patata o són la tomatera. Mm-hmm. So, Albert, could you explain us briefly what are you doing so everybody knows about your research, please?
Yeah, perfect. Actually, you know, it's quite difficult to explain briefly what I'm doing in my PhD because it's a really long topic. But anyways, yeah, I'm a computer scientist or computer engineer. Actually, my background is in computer engineering. And what I'm doing for my PhD and my research is I'm trying to study how to scale machine learning workflows in supercomputers. So I work in a supercomputing center, and in this supercomputing center, one of the things we have to do is to take really large machine learning models that would normally take like months to train in a single computer. Yep. And we figure out how can we train that in a supercomputer in like, I don't know, 1 hour or sometimes even 15 minutes. There is some record for this kind of thing, like 15 minutes or something. So yeah, that's pretty much my PhD research, the intersection between machine learning and high performance computing, basically. Have you worked with a supercomputer before?
No, no he trabajado de momento con las supercomputadoras, pero sí que entiendo un poquito porque, bueno, me introduzco un poquito a mí. Bueno, yo soy ingeniero en telecomunicaciones y, bueno, ahora mismo estoy haciendo el doctorado y está ambientado en el ámbito del 5G, que, bueno, es un tema un poco, como sabéis, un poco controvertido. Ya hablaremos de ello más adelante para debatirlo un poquito. Pero mi área de conocimiento es más bien concentrarme en una parte de 5G que es la conectividad masiva de dispositivos, que básicamente lo que hacen es enviar informaciones, por ejemplo, de temperatura, en cámaras de videovigilancia, y lo envían a la red. Entonces, el problema que tenemos con esto es que estos dispositivos tienen unos requisitos diferentes a los móviles, como pueden ser, por ejemplo, que necesiten una autonomía mucho más larga, y no necesiten tanta velocidad de bajada. Entonces, la manera como se gestiona esto es bastante diferente. Y ahí estaría un poco mi aportación en este campo.
Awesome. Gracias, Sergio.
And one question. Now that you mentioned you're working in 5G, and a lot of people know this is a very controversial topic, maybe we have a chance to resolve this problem once and for all here. Is the 5G causing coronavirus? I know it's a stupid question, but please.
Yo diría que sí. Snoop. Ya se terminamos.
So this is the fast answer.
Yeah.
This one. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. But bueno.
Yeah. Bueno, podemos debatir de esto en este momento.
In the future, we can.
Yeah, we can talk about coronavirus in 5G.
Yeah, for sure.
And it's coming.
Yeah.
I have a feeling that it's not causing coronavirus.
You have to show it.
You have to be sure. Yeah.
Okay. I look forward to that talk. I would like to have that conversation with you about coronavirus and 5G. But anyway, thank you.
Aleshores, què hem pensat nosaltres per a intentar solucionar alguns dels problemes que hem anat detectant mentre fèiem el PhD, el doctorat? Hem vist que, tot i que anàvem publicant articles i que els articles de recerca sí que tenen un impacte en un cercle molt reduït de científics del teu entorn, del teu camp, però aquest impacte i la transferència de coneixement a la resta de la societat no especialitzada és molt, molt reduït i nosaltres volíem treballar sobre això. A mi sempre m'ha agradat molt el tema de la comunicació científica i divulgar la ciència que jo anava fent a la gent que no era especialitzada en aquesta àrea. Fa uns mesos, quan vaig acabar el doctorat, se'm va ocórrer una idea per tal d'explotar al màxim tota la xarxa de científics que havíem creat, tant en la Caixa com en Amics Nostres, i li vaig donar el nom juntament a una idea que ens va aparèixer a Sergi, també a Albert i a mi, que és dir-li Sayansi. Sayansi és una paraula en suahili, una llengua africana molt, molt abundant en Àfrica, i que després ens explicarà Albert un poc més el que vol dir, però vol dir, en general, ciència.
Yep.
Aleshores, amb el projecte de Sayansi, la idea principal que volem transmetre és fer una difusió del coneixement científic des dels articles publicats o la recerca, encara que no estigui publicada, per tal que un número molt gran de gent es pugui assabentar i entendre i disfrutar d'aquest coneixement científic que anem creant els investigadors. Per tant, la difusió, el valor de difundir, seria com el primer del nostre projecte. Sergi ara ens explicarà el segon dels nostres valors.
Bueno, como ha comentado Pau, nuestro primer objetivo es difundir la ciencia al público más no especializado, básicamente para, digamos, democratizar o humanizar la investigación. Pero el problema es que también nos hemos encontrado con otra situación o con otro objetivo, que es el tema de promocionar a los jóvenes investigadores que se encuentran en situación normalmente de desamparo por parte de las instituciones, que no pueden, digamos, crecer profesionalmente dentro de sus áreas de trabajo. Y especialmente aquí en España el tema de la investigación está muy complicada y realmente el tema de ayudas es complicado. Entonces, nuestra idea también sería, aparte de difundir sobre el público no especializado, también intentar crear una especie de promoción dentro de nuestro sector y también poder crear una red de investigadores y poder hacer colaboraciones entre nosotros, dado que tenemos estas herramientas, tenemos estos contactos y creemos que sería muy interesante poder utilizarlos. Y bueno, esto sería, digamos, nuestro segundo objetivo. Y bueno, ahora Alberto os comentará un poquito nuestro tercer objetivo.
Yeah, the last one, yeah. Yeah, so as they said, like, we have a couple of objectives here, and like Pau explained, the first one, which is to diffuse science and to promote science, and the last one is to give visibility to scientists, right? Mm-hmm. And to give visibility to scientists from different walks of life, from different countries, and this kind of things. I mean, a lot of the time when you think about science, when you read a really interesting paper or you find like an interesting finding, we don't give consideration to the people behind the work, right? So one of the things we want to do is just give the visibility to these scientists, especially the young scientists like us, no? PhD mm-hmm. students, master's exactly. students and whatever, who are, you know, just trying to make it in their career and just starting their science career. So we want to give visibility to this, and we're going to be trying as much as possible to reach out to scientists in very many different parts of the world, right? We're going to go all the way to Papua New Guinea, to Africa, to Latin America, in Europe, in North America, whatever, just to find young scientists and talk to them and give them the visibility. So we're not, I mean, and in that way, we don't just promote science, but we also promote the people behind the science, which is kind of important, I mean, right? Yeah, and to do these objectives, we have
a couple of...
Sorry, before moving into the sections, could you explain a bit more about the word Sciency?
Oh, yeah.
I guess the public, our audience is like wondering.
What is Sciency? Okay, so Sciency is actually a Kiswahili word. I'm Kenyan, so obviously I speak Kiswahili as my native language. And when we were discussing the name for this, we thought, okay, what can we call it? Actually, Pau suggested we call it Sciency. I don't know how he came up with this name. And he was like, Albert, what do you call science in Kiswahili? And I said, I'm not quite sure, but I think it's Sciency, no? Well, I don't know if there is another much more like native word, but generally we call science in Kiswahili Sciency. And then we found, you know, this is super easy to pronounce because Swahili is like Spanish, no? You say things exactly the way you write them.
Yep.
So, this is important. Super easy to pronounce, super easy to say. So here we are, Sciency. after Swahili, and I'm a native Swahili speaker. So you want to say something in Swahili?
Me?
Yeah.
Show me something, whatever.
Okay, so this is the same. I usually tell people and they get surprised if this is correct or not.
Okay.
Mambo.
Mambo. Mambo.
Yeah, mambo means hi. It's like hola.
Oh, yeah.
It's,
mambo, nice. Mambo.
Mambo in Spanish.
Like you wanna...
Exactly, no? This is, there is actually a Spanish song, mambo, mambo something, mambo, jumbo something, no?
I think yeah.
From Mexico or something. Yeah, but anyway, yeah. So the simple hola is mambo.
Mambo.
And that's it.
So we'll use it from now on.
Yeah.
Albert, explain everybody how are we going to achieve these goals, because I guess you have something in mind. I have
no
idea. I have no idea.
Me neither.
We have a couple of things in mind, right? And one of the key part of it is you know, having interviews with different scientists from all parts of the world who will not just explain the science, but they will tell us the story behind the science.
Yes.
So, this is really important. We don't just want to see the results. We don't want to only focus on the results. Oh, I published a paper in Nature and it shows that coronavirus can be cured by this and this and this, no?
Or is it caused by 5G?
Or it's caused by 5G, exactly. But we want to go behind that and see the story behind the science. What actually happens in the labs? How do these people live? How do they come up with these ideas? What's the science thinking process?
Yeah, exactly.
Right? So this is very important because it humanizes the scientists more than just the science they do. And so we're going to be organizing interviews with different people from, like let me say, different scientists from all over the world. Some of them physically, some of them through Zoom and whatever. So if you're a scientist
join.
You want us to feature your work, please let us know. We're going to share the email address right below here, somewhere in right? I don't know.
Whatever.
And we can reach out to you and we can talk and you can get to tell us about your science and the great work you're doing. But that's not the only way we're going to be doing this work.
Really?
We have a couple of other plans in mind. And
Okay, Sergi, tu tens alguna idea més de lo que podem fer? Perquè, bueno, si tu me dius alguna cosa, potser a mi se m'ha acudit alguna cosa més.
Pues mira que te digo, yo creo que una buena idea quizás sería organizar entre la audiencia un trivial y que, digamos, el ganador de este trivial pues tuviera la oportunidad, el privilegio, de poder preguntar, hacer una pregunta o sacar un tema de conversación en las siguientes entrevistas. Yo creo que esto
es una buena idea.
Sí, yo creo que para conectar con la gente está bastante bien.
Otra cosa que se me está acudint es que podríem fer una secció que es diu el Throwback Thursdays.
Exacte.
Aleshores seria fer els dijous de cada setmana posar alguna publicació o un vídeo molt menut en el que explicaríem el TBT que ha dit Albert, exactament. Seria fer una publicació en la que explicaríem algun fet corregut en el passat aquell mateix dia. ¿Qué más, Sergi? ¿Alguna cosa más tens en el cap?
Sí. Estaba pensando que quizás también una mesa redonda estaría bien.
Eso es una muy buena idea.
Para debatir temas, aparte de temas técnicos, podemos debatir también temas de actualidad. Entonces, sí, podemos juntarnos, no necesariamente gente, digamos, o científicos, sino gente de muchos ámbitos, para debatir, sí, temas actuales que no sean específicamente técnicos.
You told me the other day another extra idea that I thought was quite important, Albert. So please, tell everybody about this.
Yeah.
So the last thing that we're planning to do is something called explainers. And explainers are pretty simple, right? You pick an idea, and it could be any scientist who is doing whatever topic, like you work with potatoes.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. pick whatever topic you want, and it's like a 5 to 10 minute section just explaining something interesting about this. And let me give you an example. So I work with supercomputers, and many times when I mention supercomputers to people, like, what is that? What is interesting, no? So it's just like a 5 to 10 minute section that we explain, you know, what are, how exactly are supercomputers built, how do they work, why are they interesting, why are they important for society, and these kind of things. But we want to focus on many different types of science, from biology, from physics, from chemistry, from
any interesting question.
Any interesting question, or, you know, anything that can be explained and someone feels like they can explain this topic. It's amazing. We're going to do that too. Right? So maybe I'll start, no? I'll explain supercomputers. I love supercomputers.
Yeah.
You love them?
Yeah. Really? You better do.
Well, for somebody who works with supercomputers.
Yeah, it's a must.
I don't know, man. I feel like we have a connection, right?
Okay. Bueno, pues como veréis, estamos a punto de terminar la cerveza. De hecho, yo ya me la he terminado.
Yeah.
Y bueno, muchísimas gracias por escucharnos. Esperemos que sigáis mucho tiempo con nosotros. Y bueno, y buenas tardes, y no paréis de follaros las mentes.